Well, my God called me this morning.
Hello.
My God called me this morning.
Just a little while before day.
Well, my God called me this morning.
Hello.
Let me tell you, my God called this morning.
Just a little while before day.
Well, I stopped and I listened. How sweet the voice did sound.
It sounded like a beat, beat, beating of the angels' wings,
as if from him come down. Then I stashed and I studied myself. Look, but I saw no one
till I looked
way up in glory. And so God's darling son, let me tell you that the prayer will I start to turn, and then the Spirit of God set my soul a muttering, and the prayer wheel I turned over, and I moved one step on the glory, and I rose up a
shouting,
Lord God, well, my God called me this morning.
Just a little while before day.
Then I heard the rumbling thunder.
Hello.
And I saw the sinners going under.
Just a little while before day.
And then I saw the zigzag lightning.
Hello.
And I heard the hellhound barking.
Just a little while before day.
Well, now stop. Let me tell you what my God said to me.
He said, now
you want to make it in the kingdom,
you better stay on your bended knees, my Lord.
The prayer wheel I start to bumping, and the Spirit of God set my soul jumping, and the prayer wheel I turned over, and I moved one step on the glow, and I rose up a
shouting,
Lord God Almighty. Well,
left me when times were hard and rough. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
He's kept me.
Jesus kept me.
I thought I could do it on my own, but Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
Yeah.
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
Jesus kept me.
He kept me when I wanted to do wrong.
Jesus
kept me. In a kind of a huge fashion, to fit own anatomy and that of her young. But basically, the nest is rather crude and rough. But then, as that nest graduates toward a finish, it is said that the material becomes finer and finer and finally soft and downy like cotton, so that the little eaglets can be comfortable in the nest. But when those eaglets have grown up and ought to be out scuffling for themselves, that parent eagle push them out of the nest, take them upon her back, fly out into the blue yonder, and when they are unsuspecting, she dives from beneath them and leave them flopping their little wings, trying to stay aloft. It is said that she circles around above them and watch them while they struggle. And she knows when they have become exhausted. She knows when they can't stay aloft any longer. And when they are about to go down, she dives beneath them and catches them on her back. I think God does us like us. God does us like that sometimes. I believe that sometime we find ourselves in the comfortable nest of circumstances, luxury or security or both, and we get so comfortable we don't bother to struggle. We are satisfied right where we are. Then God take us out. Allow some circumstances to develop to push us out of our nest of security. And then when we find ourselves, we're on our own wing. Well, have you felt like that sometime? Sometime in prayer, you reach out and it doesn't seem that he is there. Like Job, you go out ahead and you turn to the right and to the left. You go back over your path, and it doesn't seem that he's there. Oh, he's there all right, as he's everywhere. He's above us. He's looking down on us, but he's alive.
You see my accomplishments.
Even the good work you have begun in me.
You also see my finish. No, not half done. Every battle already won. I can't help but praise you, Lord, for the marvelous things you
trust me? What if you call me and don't feel me near you? Will you still trust me? What if I tell you to let go of the very thing that you think you have to hold? Will you trust me? Yes, I'll trust you, Lord. What if it costs my life? Yes, I'll trust you, Lord. What if I lose the very thing I love so dear? Yes. Somebody say, yes, I'll trust you, Lord. Somebody say, yes. Come on, put your hands up and say, yes, I'll trust you. I'll trust you. I'll trust you. I can hear Jesus singing. He says this.
I know the thing is easy when everything is going well. But can you still believe in me when your life's a living hell? And when all the things around you seem to quickly fade away, there's just one thing I really want to know. Will you let go?
I trust you, Lord.
Stand on my word. Against all odds, will you believe what I have said?
I trust you, Lord.
What seems impossible?
I trust you, Lord.
Will you believe?
I trust you, Lord.
Every promise that I made. You trust that I can help you, and I'll never turn away from mine. Will you trust me, child? Step I take, I will. In my troubled time,
I will.
In my sadness,
I will
trust you. In all of my hurt,
I will.
Every day.
I will.
I will.
Strong.
If I never own a mansion way out on a hill, if I never see riches, Lord, I'll serve you still. If I lose all my possessions and my health begins to fail, I can still say good. If I wake up on tomorrow, find that all of my loved ones are gone, look around and see that my friends are few, I'll still keep holding on. If I call and there's no answer in the midst of my despair, I can still say, Lord, you've been good. You've been good. Oh, yeah. So as long as I live, I'll tell the world God is good, yeah. You've been real, 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 real good to me. I'm so glad to say right now, God is good. And listen, if I never visit Paris and enjoy that midday sun, if I never sail the seven seas, oh, before my work down here is done, oh, oh, if I never see the ruins of that city they call ancient Rome, I'm not worried because I can still